Hey guys, Flip Chips here, and welcome back, and thank you again for watching and for your support. Today we're going to do another review, and I think I'm going to go and do reviews mostly from now on. I'm going to try out some Android games so that I can try it first before you play it, and I'm going to tell you, you know, what I think about the game. It's like much like what I've done before with my previous reviews. Today we're going to talk about Soul Hunters, and okay, it's an RPG by Lilith Games, and it is where you know, the usual, you have a hero and then you get to summon new heroes. They have stars, they have levels, and this game is much like everything else in its genre. You have a map here, as you can see, and you can do lots of stuff here. You can summon here the monster, summoner circle. You can summon monsters. You can do campaigns. The campaigns is, you know, it's in stages, so I played quite a lot this game now, and you know, I try to play the game as much as I can before I review it, so that I can, you know, tell you the ins and outs of the game. So for this one, well, the map is, well, it's pretty basic. It's not that easy to look at. It's complete, it's good. It's, the areas are clearly, you know, clearly seen, differentiated from one another, and there are lots of things to do. There's a guild, you can enhance your equipments here, and this game is basically your heroes. You have these heroes, you have 3 stars, 2 stars mostly, and you level them up when you get stones, soul stones. So another familiar term in these kinds of RPGs. And I've got these monsters, and you can level them up using stars, soul stones. You can level them using experience points, their base level. So the base level is dependent on your main level. And then you have equipments. You can easily go to which area you can get it, and you can sweep. You can do it on your own. So basically, it's a game where you don't spend energy. For this game, you spend food so that you can finish stages and get equipment for your heroes. And basically, they get stronger and stronger. The overall rating here. So I'm going to try to talk a little bit slower. I know I tend to speak too fast. So here you can equip the equipment, and then your heroes or, you know, your characters will get much stronger. Okay, so what else do we have here? So I have a couple of monsters here. I'm still waiting for the stars for these monsters, and my main characters are, my main party consists of mostly 3 stars hero now, 3-star heroes now. Okay, so so basically, this game isn't too tough on your cell phone. It doesn't probably require too much, you know, raw power from your processor and your video or your graphics. It's not that newbie friendly though, because it takes time to get used to the leveling up in different ways. And good thing is that there isn't too much currency in game. There's one game, I'm gonna say what it is, but I'm sure you can guess it. There are like at least 8 currencies in game. That's really hard to, you know, to instill in your mind when you're playing the game. It will take you weeks to, you know, take you weeks to get used to that type of game, and it gets boring easily. It gets, you know, it gets tough and it gets tedious. That's the worst thing that could happen. So for this one, yeah, you can do arena and you have daily quests. Yeah, got one. So that's the party EXP. It's the main EXP at level 39. You can do arena, which is the basically PvP. It's not live PvP though, so it's your hero against your opponent's party. So there are a couple of events here, and yeah, it's okay. You have daily rewards. So this is good. You have lots of things to do here. The gameplay isn't that much hard. It's basically straightforward. So I'm going to show you one battle. So let's see if I could advance one stage in the campaign. So there's a couple of maps here. So I've been through much. So this is my current party, rating of 6,600. So you choose 5 members, and you can go automatic or auto on, which is when the bars fill up, they will use their powers automatically. Okay, so I'm going to try and reduce the volume of this game. And as you can see, they're fighting automatically. If it's off, they will still fight automatically. The thing is that if it's not in auto, they won't use their skills, their special skills, if their bars are fully powered up. And it's much easier, see? You just have to watch. So basically, it's also hard to, you know the abilities of your heroes. It's not that easy if you have too many heroes to think of, if you have many games. But that's fine. So as you can see, we've won. So that's basically the gameplay. The same thing goes with PvP and the other stuff in this game. Well, basically you just choose your most powerful characters, powerful party, and you know, you just wait and try to upgrade their equipment and level up so that you can upgrade more equipment. So that's it. There are stuff to do here. Like this one, that you can reset this every day. The Crucible of Fire, you get to reset it. You can buy stuff. And you can summon here in the summoner circle campaign mailbox where you get your rewards. And there are stuff to do here. The good thing here is that it's friendly, and that is because you don't get to access everything when you start. When you level up your party, in time you will gain access to, like this one. I'm still level 13, so I can't access this. And I don't even know what's the name of this area. What the name of this area is. So the rest I have unlocked and I have to wait. So this one, 42, almost there, the treasure cave. This one, level 35, so I can't access it yet. So the good thing here is that as you advance, you don't get overwhelmed with all of, just imagine if all the areas will be available for you when you start the game. It will be overwhelming. Okay. Now it doesn't get updated from time to time. But that's okay. So it's okay. So, this is a game that you can play for quite a long time. I'm pretty sure. You might enjoy this if you love this type of game. And I'm not sure though. Well, for the graphics, it's simple. It's as you can see with the battle that we had. It's as simple as that one. It's not that flashy. It's more like an animation, a cartoon, but that's okay. It doesn't really affect the gameplay. Okay, and now for online access, it requires constant connection to the internet, so it cannot be played offline. It's fine. You can probably play this even on a 3G. I've tried it, and you know, it doesn't connect easily, but that's fine. It will connect eventually. And most of all, this game is free, and advertisements are not infused within the gameplay, so it won't bother your gameplay. That's really good. There are in-app purchases, you can get more heroes, more stuff. But of course, as I've always said, in-app purchases will depend on you. Okay, and the ad infusion, again, so yeah, there's not much advertisement, so that's good. And the overall gameplay fun factor, well, it's an average, so that's fine, it's okay. Okay, so now, so we've seen the games, that's just an overview. So again, for gameplay, I'm going to give this a 3, since you won't really interact with your heroes. You just have to play it automatically, and that's pretty much it. You just level up your equipment, your heroes, and you're done. So it's 3 out of 5. Graphics and audio, it's not the best, so I'll give it a 3. And audio, it's pretty simple, as you have heard. And I've lost. Okay. It's not that good, but it's okay, so I'll give it a 3. Engagement, yes, you have to check each of your characters' equipments and levels. So you have to do it yourself, basically. So it takes a. So because of that, you get used to playing the game. So that's good. So I'll give it a 3.5. Long-term value. If you like this game, it will keep you occupied for a long, long time. So I'm going to give it a 3.5. Price, it's, you know, it's okay. You can play this game even without paying anything. So that's a major, major plus. You can do this without, you know, paying or buying in-app purchases. So that's plus to everyone. You can try out the game even if you don't purchase anything. Although you progress much slower compared to those who paid for the game or paid for something in the game. Okay, so that's it. So overall, it's 3.4. It's good to try. It's not that difficult. It takes time to get used to. It's basically your. I don't know what to call these types of games. Idle RPG. Because you just play, you know, wait for something, wait for your energy. So, and it's fine. So that's the way it is. So it's a good game. I'm enjoying it. I'm not sure until when I will enjoy it. I will enjoy it, but you feel free to try it out. So again, thank you for watching, and you know, have a good day, guys. Enjoy your game.